Yes, dear students, in last class we have discussed about the electric potential and electric potential due to a point charge. Now electric potential due to a point charge is nothing but, here we got the expression is nothing but V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R. At the same time, from the definition of electric potential we got one relation, that is V is equal to work done by charge. That means electric potential is nothing but work done to bring the charge, okay, from infinity to a given point. Okay, next, thereafter our topic is electric potential due to a dipole. About electric potential due to a dipole we have to discuss in this class, right? Actually we have studied dipole, electric dipole concept in electric charges and fields chapter. In first chapter we have discussed. Now first electric dipole we will take. Sir, what is the electric dipole? Electric dipole is a system in which two charges equal in magnitude, opposite in direction, are separated by a small distance. Such arrangement or such system is said to be here electric dipole. Now look at the board here. I am going to show here electric dipole. Now this is the one of the charge, okay, the charge is nothing but plus Q charge. Okay, here plus Q charge has placed at a point P. Now here what I am taking, another charge, okay, the charge is nothing but minus Q charge. This minus Q charge has placed at a point B, okay, has placed like this. Now thereafter these two charges are separated by a small distance. The distance is equivalent to 2a means, okay, now this system is said to be electric dipole. Of course if you draw the, okay, line joining from positive charge to negative charge means, okay, this line is said to be here dipole axis. Dipole axis. Now this is the midpoint of the dipole, which is represented by a letter, that is nothing but A. Now here, okay, from point A, this one is nothing but X mark, right? Next, this is the arrangement of the dipole. Every electric dipole is having dipole moment. Dipole moment is a vector quantity. The direction of the vector quantity, dipole moment direction, is from where to where it directed, means it direct from negative charge to positive charge. Now this is the negative charge towards positive charge. We have to show the dipole moment direction. That electric dipole moment is denoted by a letter, is nothing but P bar. Now due to this complete dipole, due to this complete dipole, we have to derive the electric potential at any one of the point. The point where I am going to take here means, here I am going to take considerable point. Okay, the name of the point is nothing but P at this point. Okay, now this point is, right, at a distance R. Now from this center of the dipole, this considerable point is at a distance R. Now at this distance R, due to this complete dipole, we have to find out the electric potential at this point. Right, sir, in this dipole, from this positive charge, what is the distance of the point B? From this positive charge means, the distance is nothing but what I can take here means, that is R1. It is located at a distance R1. Next, from negative charge, the dipole is, from the negative charge of dipole, okay, the considerable point is being at a distance of how much mark? That is nothing but R. Now due to this complete dipole, from the center of the dipole, the considerable point is at a distance R1. From the positive charge, the point is at R1. From the negative charge, the point is at R2. Now due to this complete whole dipole, here we have to find out the electric potential. Now to find out this one, first of all if you look at here, what I am going to write means, due to this first point charge, plus Q charge, what is the electric potential at this point? First we will write,
Next, look at here. Electric potential. Electric potential at P due to which charge? Plus Q charge. Due to plus Q charge. Okay, that electric potential V1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Look at here. Electric potential due to a single charge. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q means plus Q divided by R means from here to here distance. How much is there? From point here to point B. The distance is nothing but R. Next two. Look at here. Electric potential. Electric potential at P due to which charge? Negative charge. Due to negative charge. Yes. Now due to this negative charge at point P, what is the electric potential means? V2 is equal to, we can write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q, which Q mark? Minus Q. Minus Q divided by what I can write? I can write R2. R2 is the distance. See, due to positive charge, you may get here plus sign. Due to negative charge, you may get the negative sign. According to this sign, potential, it may positive or negative. For positive sign, potential is positive. For negative sign, potential is negative. Now, the question is, look at here. Okay, net electric potential. Net electric potential at P due to dipole. Now, due to positive charge, we got electric potential. Due to negative charge, we have here, electric potential. Now, due to this whole charge, due to this whole dipole, what is the electric potential at this point? Means, right, we can write net electric potential at P, comma V is equal to, we can write V1 plus V2. Net potential means we have to make it arrow by the simple algebra. Why? Because potential is a vector. Now thereafter, V is equal to electric potential at point P is equal to V1 is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R1 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught V2 is nothing but what is there? Minus Q divided by R2. Now from this one, what are the terms I am going to take it common means? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q common. So Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, 4 pi epsilon naught common. So you make it here 1 divided by R1 minus into plus minus 1 divided by R2 we may have. Now this is nothing but equation number 1. This is the equation number. Right, afterwards, let's look at here how we are going to simplify the concept. Now actually, here 1 by R1 is there, here 1 by R2 is there. From the geometry of this diagram, to simplify this equation, let us have R1 is equal to R square plus A square minus 2RA cos theta. 2RA cos theta. In similar way, R2 is equal to R square plus A square plus 2RA cos theta we can take this. Right? Like this we can take. For R1, we will take R square plus A square minus 2RA cos theta. Now, R2 equal to R square plus A square plus, here the difference is nothing but only plus and minus. Now, this one I am going to write from the geometry of figure. You just remember this one, why? Because, for this one, is there, simplification also is there, but that is not need, not given in the textbook also. So simply you just remember this one. Right, now from this one, first I am going to take R1 for simplification. R1 square, R2 square integral. Okay, R1 square equal to, now what we are having here, R square plus, okay, A square minus 2RA cos theta. Of course, I have taken. Next, from this one, R1 square equal to, what I can write here, R1 square equal to, okay, here, in this complete term, R square if you take it common. Sir, R square if I take it common means, here complete R square has came outside. So, 1 plus, here, A square is there, but there is no R square. So, what we may get? A square divided by R square, right? You multiply with it, R square into A square will come here. Here a square, both are get cancelled. Next one, minus 2a cos theta divided by r. We may have it like this. Here already r is there. Okay, then what happened? You just see here, after multiplication, right, what will becomes here means, that becomes r. Here r square is there, so 1 I got. Here no r square is there because of its denominator, r square has came. Here one single r is there. That's why here one single hair has become taken. Now this is common things in mathematics already we have seen. Now if you observe my here one thing, what is that means? R value is, this r value is very much greater than a. A value is very small. R value is very large. So what I can write means, since R square is greater than A. What is that? E R value is greater than A. Then what we can do means, okay, A square by R square can be negative. Can be negative. Notama R value A kinta tumba jaasti. Avaga tumba jaasti value denominator alli ide, numerator alli tumba kadame ide. So resultant of this one is very small, so we can neglect it. Then after neglecting, R1 square equal to, we are having here, R square, bracket begin, 1 minus 2a cos theta divided by, of course, I can write R. Now from this one, R1 is equal to, error kade, square root apply maadidini, so here R square will becomes R into 1 minus 2a cos theta divided by r whole power 1 by 2. Root of this complete value means, we can write like this, square root of that. Next, afterwards what I can write here means 1 by r1. Okay, this one I am making reciprocal. So, 1 by r1 is equal to 1 by r into, and this value is complete becomes 1 minus 2a cos theta divided by r whole power minus 1 by 2. Okay, we can. Next, afterwards, we just see how we are going to simplify this one. Okay, 1 by r1, this 1 by r1, 1 by r1 is equal to 1 by r into, how to solve this one? You just see by applying the binomial theorem. Right, next look at here, by using binomial theorem. Okay, by using the binomial theorem, how we can write now this one? Okay, this equation will becomes, look at the board, 1 by r1 is equal to 1 by r into bracket begin 1 minus r. Whatever the value is there, this value will come and multiply at this point. Next to minus of minus 1 by 2, our remaining is 2a cos theta divided by r. Is there? Next to this 2 and this 2, both are cancelled. After cancel, 1 by r1 is nothing but 1 by r into 1 plus r. Here, minus into minus plus 1 plus a cos theta divided by r, I can write. Now this is nothing but r1 value. This r1 value is nothing but equation number 2 we can take. Similarly, 1 by r1 value I got. R1 square current, okay, 1 by R1 value I got. Similarly, 1 by R2 is equal to 1 by R into, we may get 1 minus A cos theta divided by R limit. Now, like this, see, here the difference is minus plus. Due to minus, here we got plus, means due to this plus, here we may get is nothing but minus. Now, from equation 2 and 3, we get equation 1 becomes equation 1. Becomes, look at here. Where is the equation 1? Here. V is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon. In both terms, what is the common thing? 1 by R. So 1 by R, if you take it common, means 1 by R1. Here, 1 by R1. In 1 by R1, 1 by R common is there. In 1 by R2, 1 by R is also common. So what I have read here means, okay, in both things, 1 by R is the common, so I am writing outside. And thereafter, once again, V1, 1 by R1, 1 by R1 means, 1 by R I have taken common, 1 plus A cos theta divided by R minus, bracket begin, minus 1 minus A cos theta divided by R begin. Yes? Right.
Look at there.
Once again. Right. First of all, 1 by R1, when I am going to substitute 1 by R1, in 1 by R1 and in 1 by R2, 1 by R is common is there, so both terms I have taken 1 by R common. Then thereafter, 1 by R1 value, 1 plus A cos theta by R minus of 1 by R2 value, 1 minus A cos theta divided by R. Right thereafter, Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R I have taken common. So remaining terms are nothing but 1 plus A cos theta divided by R, minus, I am going to multiply, minus 1 into 1 is nothing but 1. Okay, thereafter, minus into minus plus A cos theta divided by R I may have. So plus 1, minus 1 are get cancelled. Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R. Afterwards, A cos theta, A cos theta by R. A cos theta by R, A cos theta by R. Is nothing but 2A cos theta by R. 2A cos theta divided by, I can get here, R. Next one. Thereafter, potential V equal to this one, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, I can get. Next one. Q into 2A. Look at here, this Q is 2A. Okay, Q into 2A is nothing but electric dipole moment, that is P. So, P remaining is cos theta divided by R into R, R square I can. Right, since here bracket, you know, bracket, right? Okay, P equal to Q into 2A, of course, I can. So, electric potential due to a dipole is nothing but how I can write, means I can write like this. V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon r p cos theta divided by r. Suppose if the cos theta, theta is 90 degree. If theta is 90 degree, theta 90 degree means cos 90 value is 0. Cos 90 value 0 means if theta is 0, potential is 0. Potential 0 means that line is simply here on equatorial line. This is equatorial line. Right. Theta value is 90 degree. Theta value is 90 degree means, okay, here the theta will be here. Instead of this point, okay, at point here, suppose if you take perpendicular, in that case electric potential is 0. Suppose if you take theta equal to 0 or 180 degree, that means 0 or 180 degree means, suppose if the point you take it either exactly on this line, exactly on this line, in that case electric potential V is equal to, we will write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P divided by R square. Amen. Okay, here in electric field and charges you have studied electric field due to the dipole on axial line and equatorial line. In this chapter it is not like this, separate derivations are not there, but one common derivation is there. From the common derivation we can write what is the electric potential on equatorial line and on axial line also. Again, now this is the very very important concept. Yes, make a note. Yes, dear students, next our topic is electric potential due to system of charges. Now let us consider what are those q1 comma q2 comma q3 and so on qn. How many number of charges are there? N number of charges are there. System of n number of charges are there. Okay, this system of n number of charges are located at R1 comma R2 comma R3 and so on Rn distances from a point. Right, the Q1, Q2, Q3 and so on Q1 are system of charges are located at R1, R2, R3 and so on Rn distances from a considerable point. So look at the diagram. Here I am going to take now this is nothing but one point. From this point, okay, here Q1 charge is there. Now the distance from Q1 charge to P is nothing but how much? R. Here Q2 charge is there. Okay, from the point P, this Q2 charge is at a distance R. Now at a distance R3, see there is another charge Q3 is there. In similar way, at a distance Rn from P, see there is another charge Rn is there. Now like this, some n number of charges are there. This n number of charges are at a distance R1, R2, R3 and so on Rn from this considerable point. Okay, now due to this all system of charges, what is the electric potential at this point? That what we have to find. Now very first one, what I am going to write here means electric potential at P due to Q1 charge, what is the electric potential at point? Is nothing but V1 is equal to, we can write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 divided by R1. Distance is R1. Next, electric potential at P due to Q2 charge, what is the electric potential? V2 equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 divided by R2 and so on, like this one and so on. How are I can write? Electric potential at P due to which charge? Q1 charge. Due to Q1 charge, here electric potential. Vn is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Qn divided by R2. Okay, like this. Sorry, Rn. Okay, like this. Now the question is, what is the net electric potential at P due to all the system of charges we have to consider. Okay, now look at here. by the superposition principle, comma, net electric potential due to system of charges, electric potential due to system of charges is algebraic sum of individual potential, algebraic sum of potential due to individual charges, algebraic sum of potentials due to which charges ma? individual charges. Algebraic sum means how we have to write, sir? Algebraic sum means simply we can write, that means net potential at point P is equal to we may write V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus and so on plus Vm, we can write from this one. V1 is nothing but here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 divided by R1 plus V2 is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 divided by R2 plus V3 and R2 will take. Okay, keep on and placing the so on. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Qn divided by Rn. Okay. Now from this one, what are the terms are going to cancel? Potential at P equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is common. So remaining is Qn by R1 bracket begin plus Q2 by R2 plus and so on plus remaining Qn divided by Rn. Now by this, okay, superposition principle we can measure. Finally, potential at P equal to, I can write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. These all terms are sum. Okay, sum of all the terms. Sum means summation you take. Summation I is equal to 1 to L. What are the terms are there? Qi divided by Ri. Now this is nothing but electric potential due to the system of charges. Okay, topic is not that much important, but during the solvings the problems, this concept is important. But whatever it may be, according to our syllabus, this topic is there also there. That's why I have done this. Right? Yes.